This video is brought to you by Storyblogs Video. Hey folks, Jordy here for CineCam.net and welcome to Creative Tuesday. Now I've got 5 tips today to make your animations look amazing inside Adobe Premiere Pro. And we're gonna kick it off with the first one, keyframe hold. Not many people seem to use it, but when you're animating the position of a text, for instance, you could right-click on any of the keyframes, temporal interpolation, and then choose hold. And this will make sure that the animation to the right will not pursue if you have another keyframe there. And this can be useful if you like to let your text jump to another position or any other property. And this means that you don't need to create an extra keyframe or add cuts in your clips. An interesting use of this is where you animate a text to move around in position every time you leave a couple of frames in between. When we play this, the text will animate around, but if we then select all of the keyframes, right-click, temporal interpolation, hold, that text will now jump around. And by adding one of our free-to-download glitch presets onto the text, you will get a very nice text animation. You can download these for free from a link in the description below. And if you would like to download more templates, effects, transitions, and so much more, then I can highly recommend to check out Storyblogs Video. Now, these guys are not just our sponsor. We've been working together for a very long time now. It's basically a huge library where you can download unlimited premium video assets from. We've also added a bunch of sparks, muzzles, and light leak effects that everyone can download and use in commercial work without additional fees. Now, tons of new assets are being added every day, and Storyblogs also makes sure to keep their library updated. For more information, make sure to click the first link in the description below. And now moving on to tip number 2, we're gonna explore the keyframes a little bit further. Whenever you create an animation where a layer starts from point A, moves to point B, and then stops at point C, you'll notice that the text will actually go into a curve around point B. Now Premiere actually does this automatically, but we can turn that off. If you select all the keyframes, right-click, and then choose Spatial Interpolation, and then choose Linear, now your text will go into a straight path. And of course, you can turn that curve back on by choosing Bezier from the Spatial Interpolation menu. And you can actually change the curve of that path with the levers on the side of the animation keyframes. So spatial interpolation defines the curve of the path, but then there's also temporal interpolation, which is gonna define the speed of the animation, and we've talked about this more on the channel. When you have a text going from point A to point B, it will start and stop pretty hard. So what you can do is right-click on the first keyframe, temporal interpolation, and then ease out. For your last keyframe, we'll do the same thing, but now choose ease in. And this will let the animation start and stop smooth, which feels a lot more natural. Now the reason why we say ease out with the first keyframe is that an animation always goes from the left to the right. So the animation will start after the first keyframe and stop before the last keyframe. Choosing ease out means that the animation out of the keyframe to the right will be smoothened. And same goes for the last keyframe. Here you choose ease in as we're going into the keyframe, coming from the left. Alright, tip number 3. We've got some smooth keyframes now and we would like to adjust exactly how smooth they should be. To do that, you can expand the property that you've just animated from the left side. And this reveals the curves. And by pulling on the levers of any of the keyframes, you'll be able to choose that. For example, the starting keyframe has to start very slow and then accelerate. You could do the same thing with the last keyframe, which lets your element slowly accelerate, then speed up very fast and stop very slowly at the last point. And there are many things that you can do with the velocity curves to really create a natural and playful animation. For example, have a text start super slow and then speed up super fast on the end. Or make it start slow and go fast in the middle and then go slow again. Now, I'm actually showcasing this all with the normal motion property. But if you're animating the motion, I would actually suggest to use the transform effect, which has the same properties, but it also has an extra option called shutter angle. When you disable to use the composition shutter angle and set one of your own, for example, the natural 180 degree, you'll also introduce motion blur in your animations, which will look more natural. And now that we know how to fully control the keyframes of an element, we can start creating realistic animations. However, the physics of an object is never easy to guess. So here's a quick solution that might help. Let's say that you want to create a ball bouncing on the ground, going back and forward a dozen of times to tweak the animation. But you can make it yourself easy by just filming that action. Just drop a ball in your frame. In Premiere Pro, you could place a circle on top of that clip, create a keyframe for the position of that circle, and simply animate it with the ball every time it bounces. Now, to get the same physics, you could then adjust the spatial interpolation or the curves of the animation path, and finally the curves of the animation speed. And this will go a lot faster, and the result is usually a lot more natural. And that brings us to the last animation tip. Whenever you're going to work with multiple elements, you want to create an efficient workflow. And there are two important tools that are going to help you with that. For example, here I have a box and animated a text that comes into the box. Now I want to reveal this text as it comes into that box, and one way to do that is by using the crop effect. But when I then want to change my animation, I will also need to adjust the crop. So make it yourself easy and create an adjustment layer from the New Item button, then place that on top of your edits and apply the crop effect on there. Now it will also crop into your backgrounds, but we can fix that by selecting your element layers, right-click and choose Nest. To change your animation now, you open up the nested sequence, disable the adjustment layer and move your text around or change the animation. Now, a second way is by using the track mat. Basically, you can create any shape you like. Cropping around the edges of this shape is going to be really hard. So what it'll do is make a duplication of that shape and add a white fill to this duplication. Then search for the track mat key effect and drag it over to the duplication. Important now is that your text or animated element sits on top of this duplication. Then from the track mat controls, select the text layer. This duplicate will now disappear and only function as the area in which the text may appear. And interesting enough, you could create complex animations on a white plane and use it as a custom transition. You could make two clips overlap, like you can see here, then place your alpha animation on top of there, add the track mat effect to the top clip, and change the mat to the transition animation. A super simple trick to create some unique transitions. And those were my 5 tips for better animations. Thank you all so much for watching. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. Definitely check those guys out by clicking that first link in your description below. But more importantly, stay creative. So the other day, a salesman came to the studio and he sold me a cleaning mop. But not just the cleaning mop itself, they're actually selling me a service to wash this mop every 2 weeks, and now I'm stuck to this contract. But it's a good mop though.
God damn, this is expensive!